sports. It's in the game.
Stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in the slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you want to do is talk, I don't need to talk.
Gotta hurry, somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca that. Banging my chest and my head on the lock. Feeling like,
yeah. Turn me up, then it's over some time. Hold up, check me out. I think the tables and turn. Forget the bridges we done built. This time I let them all burn. They tried to count me out. Well, now it's the word. I bring in paper, paper, paper from the first to the first. They count me out. Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling. They count me out. It all begins.
Right here.
Right now. Catch me if you can. Total catch up. But I still can't even see them from the view. Got my check up. And now I'm trying to blow a bag of two. Proud of shoes. Designer, drink it what I desire. Put him out, what I told him, cause that boy he on fire. Walk in that thing and air it up, and in my bag a little bit. Remember my.
Today, from Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin, this is the National Football League. And the Green Bay Packers taking on Justin Fields and the Chicago Bears.
There's a look at one of the most iconic sports venues in the lower 48, built back in 1957 under the title of City Stadium. We are at Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin. We all know this community lives for its Packers, and the green and gold came out of the tunnel a short time ago, and it was loud. We are ready for football, so are they, as the Packers get set to match up with the Chicago Bears. And we will not get a run back here to start. It's a touchback, and it will come out to the 25. So here are the Bears now for their opening drive. They'll be led out by a first-round pick back in 2021 from Ohio State. It's Justin Fields.
Coming out of Ohio State, it was so big that they moved up in the draft to get him, to make sure that they had him. And, boys, he got the full package. Loves the game. Big-time arm. 4-4 speed. So good that another quarterback prospect said to him, what's it feel like to run 4-4? Everybody wants to be that fast.
Play action. It's Fields. And this will be caught by Mooney. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. The game's first play produces 6 yards. Brings up second down. One play action, Fields. There's Mooney with another catch. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Brandon, I think we can see early on they're making a concerted effort to get him the football. So to me, that means they like the matchup that they have. They feel like he's better than the guys that are covering him.
Two plays, two passes. We'll see if they go back to that well. So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Here's Fields. And his throw is incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Here's the first carry for Tariq Cohen. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Throwing on third down, Fields. Fighting through pressure. Disaster there, resulting in a loss of 7 on third down. So on fourth down, on is the punter, Pat O'Donnell, to kick it away. And that one hits at the 7, but bounds into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. Veteran Green Bay quarterback Aaron Rodgers ready to go for drive number 1 along with the rest of this Packer offense.
There have been very few quarterbacks in the NFL who have been as consistent throughout their career as Aaron Rodgers. He's been good for so long, and we've seen no decline in his skills. His accuracy and arm strength continue to elevate the talent around him, and his in-game mistakes, few and far between.
Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up first and 10 at the 20. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5. After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. To throw, it's Rodgers. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's 3rd down.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't. And that's caught inside the 35. Touchdown. Devontae Adams, 75 yards. And the Packers have taken the early lead. So on 3rd and medium, they dial up the pass, and it works to hit the end zone.
And it's really not a surprise to me. That's a throwing down in the NFL because of how tough it is to run the football. But what offenses like to do is still show run formations to make them respect it and throw out of those. In this case, they took a nice shot at the end zone and made it pay off.
On is Mason Crosby for the point after. And it's good to make it 7-0 Packers. So the drive there, they went 80 yards in 3 plays. And it ends with a Packers touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as Grant opts not to return it. Chicago works their way back onto the field here for their 2nd drive of the game. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football. 1-0, make 5, 6, 7 yards on 1st down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating 1st downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
On 2nd and 10, Fields. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
Partney sold the go route really well. Thought he was going deep, then curled it back inside for a nice completion.
DBs love when they pump the brakes, don't they?
Yeah, that's really a whole lot cool. Of fun. It's almost like you said, listen, if you're going to sell the go, just go, and let's see who's faster.
And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. Well, I think the hope is, you know, with a touch pass like that, maybe you catch the defense off guard, but they were all over that one.
And it is the kind of play that works better against certain defenses, and this clearly was the wrong one to run into. Really nice job getting him down behind the line of scrimmage.
First carry now for David Montgomery. And he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
From the gun on 3rd down, Fields. And he finds his tight end, Graham. And he can only manage to take the football to the 40, and that is well shy of the 1st down marker. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's 4th down.
Well, the good thing about covering any game I do with you is I know that there's no problem with rhythm. Now, what we're watching watching offensively. A little bit of a problem there.
Yeah, punt on the first drive. Looking at another one here. Just a little slow. It, you know, they were talking about a fast start, but that hasn't been the case.
Yeah, and let's face it. Any team we cover always talks about a
fast
start.
That's true.
But it's not necessarily going to happen just because they say so. And whether it's the script, whether it's, you know, just what they're going through, whether they're seeing different defenses, they're going to have to figure it out as this game moves on.
On the return, it's Rodgers. So holding there on the return, and that'll back him up to start the next drive.
Yeah, that's a pretty easy call right there, partner. I think when the officials look in their manual and see the expression, jersey getting pulled, that's a flag coming out every time.
When the holding penalty sets them back inside the 20 as they get going on this drive. They fake the give. Now Rodgers looking deep for Adams. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. And here's another tackle made at the line. So they're converging well on the football now. Throwing is Rodgers on third down. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Robert Quinn in there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that will lead to fourth down. Here's Corey Bohorquez now. Back deep, Jakeem Grant. After one, 7-0, EA Sports. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
So give him the yardage on the completion and also tack on 15 more.
If you get that hand up there, you've got to let go immediately or just not close the hand at all. He didn't, gave it a tug, and that was easy for the official.
Touchdown, Bears! Marquise Goodwin from 13 yards out. And the Bears are an extra point away from tying the football game. And there they got him the ball, just get it to him, let him do the rest.
You know, he probably said that to his quarterback as he broke the huddle. I like the play call. Just get it to me. I'll take care of the rest of it.
Helping out his rack, right? RAC?
Run after catch, and he loves that, and he's going to carry that in at contract time.
Cairo Santos on to try the extra point. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in court. They got the ball in great field position. One play later, boom, end zone. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Rodgers going to return it from his end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. The Packers ready to take over offensively. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. On play action, Rodgers. And it's complete to Adams. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. Throwing on first down is Rodgers. Setting up the screen here, Aaron Jones. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. On second down, Dillon. And he'll get it down to the 47 here.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10 at the 47. Back to the ground, this time with Jones. And he'll work this forward for about 3. It's second down. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Play action. Now it's Rodgers. Man open, that's Marquez Valdes-Scantling. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears 23. Adams, touchdown, Green Bay. Devontae Adams with his 2nd touchdown here in this first half. And the Packers have taken the lead. Now he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
It's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, 2 touchdowns already here through the 2nd quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
By Crosby, and that makes the score 14-7. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Brand, he will not return it, and his guys will begin at the 25. David Montgomery ready to take the field for the Bears' next possession. You can count his carries on 1 finger. They've only given him the rock 1 time, Charles. What gives?
So we can't draw any conclusions just yet. He has to touch the ball multiple times in order to get into a rhythm and have a chance to have success. You know who else gets into a rhythm? The offensive line. They feel better about what they're doing when they know they've had multiple opportunities to get it done.
Yeah, well, the conclusion we draw so far, they're losing here in the 2nd quarter. Let's see if they change tunes. First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's 2nd and 12. Now Montgomery running right. A great move by Montgomery. Broke a tackle, but not much room there ultimately. Just up past the 25 and no further.
We've called a lot of games, but we don't normally talk about inside linebackers being that fleet of foot, do we?
No, he was able to get outside there to make that play.
Yeah, and you know what makes them faster? Their ability to read plays, understand what offenses are trying to do, and put themselves in proper position.
We've hit the 2-minute mark of the 2nd quarter, 14-7. A reminder coming up in a couple of minutes' time, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman, the coach in our EA Sports studios. They'll have a look back at the next-gen stats from this first half of action. Yeah, that's good for a gain of 6, and that'll make it a 2nd down. Fields going to hurry his guys to the line. And now a hook up downfield on 2nd down. Touchdown, Chicago! Marquise Goodwin with his 2nd touchdown here in this first half. And the Bears are an extra point away from tying the football game. Well, I love watching Goodwin play. Of course, everybody knows the story of him being an Olympian. He's a long jumper,
yes,
right?
Yes.
But you know that he has that athletic.
Does, and not only was he an Olympian as a long jumper, married to a sprinter. How about that for speed in one family? And I love his end zone celebrations now. When he does go deep and beat someone for a touchdown, now he does the long jump as his celebration. Pretty cool deal.
Santos able to tack on the extra point, and we are tied here in the 2nd quarter. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Rodgers on the return. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And he is going to have a Packers first down by about a yard as they're able to convert on third and two. Now Rodgers. Oh, there's Tonyan. What a catch. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. Off the play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And this is caught inside the five. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll try and pound it in with Dillon. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. A.J. Dillon, a three-yard touchdown run. And the Packers have moved out in front. So it was the passing game that got him down here, but closer to the goal line, it's the running game that gets him home.
Certainly appears that they lulled the defense into thinking that the passing game was going to be it the entire time to get him over the goal line.
Extra point try now for Crosby. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-14. That time, a six-play drive. And it was A.J. Dillon who capped it off with a touchdown run. Touchdown. Here's Crosby to kick it away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Here comes Justin Fields and the rest of the Bears offense. You know, normally he's probably happy with how he's playing. He's playing pretty well, but in the second quarter, you look up, your team's losing. I don't think any quarterback's satisfied.
Not at all. And what they're really seeking is, how do I play even better and inspire my teammates to do exactly the same in order for us to get back on top on the scoreboard? That's when you find out you have a quarterback. If they're just satisfied with their stat line,
they're not really a leader.
Not at all. You just have a guy playing the position.
Fields on first down. That's complete to Mooney. Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one. From the 41, Fields. Now the Packers give him nowhere to go and they bring him down. Now a signal and a timeout call as it comes with 9 seconds to go in this first half of play. So now following the sack, Fields and the Bears looking at third down and long. Out of the gun, Fields. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked up by the former Bear, Adrian Amos. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. On now is Mason Crosby, who's hit from as far as 58 in his career. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And this is good from 57 yards. So we're at halftime here at Lambeau with the Packers taking the lead to the break. As we send you down to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome, everyone, to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome in, everyone, to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. Back and forth, we win in that first half. This has certainly been an entertaining one to watch thus far. So let's get right back out to it, as we'll rejoin our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Rodgers on the return. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. Devontae Adams and the Packer offense heading back out.
And I know that they've double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it?
Right.
Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
Second down, another shot for Jones. And this time not as successful, as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. And they're going to speed things up here. Now a play fake. Rodgers. Looking deep for Adams. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. A big play there. Rodgers to Adams. 49 yards.
I guess that answers the question of whether or not they're going to try to play conservative and protect this lead in the third quarter.
And I think this is something we're seeing more and more of in the NFL. Teams not playing to protect leads, teams playing to extend them.
On play action, it's Rodgers. Flush to his right. And that will be caught, but out of the end zone, says the field judge. It's ruled incomplete. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. The give is to Jones. And he'll get a couple here down to the 22. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Again, it's Jones. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Now Jones, and running room hard to come by, rating from the 8-yard line. Now they'll throw with Rodgers. This is caught. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. Well, he gets attended to, we'll step aside. Now they've gotten it to the 1. Can they get that final yard here on 3rd and goal? Dillon is in. Touchdown, Packers. Well, nothing fancy there, Charles. You had 3 tight ends on the field. They were going to run the football. The defense knew it, but the defense couldn't stop it.
And I haven't met an offensive line yet that doesn't get more satisfaction out of running the football into the end zone than pass protecting. They had determination on their side, and they got it done.
Now Crosby for the point after. And that'll make this a 3-score game as the lead moves to 17. So that drive consumes 9 plays all told. And it was A.J. Dillon who capped it off with a touchdown run. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as Grant opts not to return it. So here are the Bears now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now.
He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Well, here's a good way to kick off a drive, complete over the middle. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Running left, Montgomery. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Fields now to throw. And this throw will be intercepted. Picked off by Jair Alexander. And the Packers are going to take possession here at their own 47-yard line. Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted, but they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result could be something you don't like.
Here's Jones again on second down. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. Rodgers now on first down. This one to the right, caught by Valdez-Scantling. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a 3-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league.
He hauls it in. Valdez-Scantling for the Packers touchdown. Marquez Valdez-Scantling there to make the grab. And the Packers add 6 to their lead.
No lead safe in the new NFL, but this score is really going to give them some needed breathing room.
Extra point try now for Crosby. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. So that drive, 4 plays, and the result, a Green Bay score. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Grand, he will not return it, and his guys will begin at the 25. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
They'll start things on first with Tariq Cohen. Whatsoever. Second and 10.
I don't think any of us were surprised that they decided to start this drive on the ground after the last two drives ended in interceptions.
Unfortunately, though, not a lot going on that first play.
Yeah, I think the anticipation was felt also by the defense.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. To throw is Fields. The connection made. It's Graham. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
We'll put that one in the win column for the defense. Trying to contain tight ends in the passing game is so difficult nowadays, but they did in a big way there.
From the gun, here's Fields. That's complete to a speedy wideout, Goodwin. And he'll get this one way up, just shy of the 45-yard line.
With the kind of game he's had so far, you had to know that on third down, that they would be looking his way, and they did, for big yardage and a first down. I think the defense fell asleep at the switch on that one. I would have doubled him, tripled him, anything to keep the ball out of his hands.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Now a first down throw, Fields. He'll drop this one down to Cohen. That catch good for only a couple. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it. That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Now Fields. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Jair Alexander. And into the end zone. It's a pick six and a Packer touchdown. Defensively, they've had their way in this one. That pick six makes that scoreboard even more lopsided.
I remember talking with a guy in the league, and I said, what do you do when the game's like this? You know, it's pretty much over. You ready to go to the bench and hang out? And he said, oh, heck no. I want to stay on the field. I might get some stats. I might get a pick or two.
You like being out there at the end of these wide margins.
When they have to throw it, that gives you more opportunities to go get it.
Now Crosby for the point after. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. Option navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. Here's Jakeem Grant from his end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The Bears offense ready to get going again. And you can sort of sense their dejection. That last pick six put the icing on the cake, so to speak, in what has been a rough go for them. After the interception, Fields. He'll get that complete to his tight end, Cole Kmet. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there, it's going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Fields. He's going to dump that off to his running back, Cohen. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way. And really, we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
Second and 2. Now it's Fields. He'll get that complete to his tight end, Kmet. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They can go ahead and mark it in the win column. But as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them, gets big yardage, and puts points on the board. They have pride, too, on that side of the ball.
Now a man open down the middle of the field. And he's going to get this inside the 30. He's certainly been a huge factor in this one. He's got the two touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him? Double him, triple him, do what you have to do. But sometimes.
He certainly looks to be in that groove right now. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Here's Fields. And a quick throw here. That's complete. And he's across for the touchdown. Too little, too late, but he does get in for 6.
No wonder you're grinning. You just beat me in our fantasy league.
Indeed I did, my good man. Solid response that time by a young quarterback. Last drive, interception. This drive, the touchdown pass.
I like how you described it, solid, because
You don't get extra kudos for bouncing back if you're going to be a big-time quarterback. You're supposed to do that. But at the same time, when you're a rookie, that's not guaranteed, is it? Sometimes they hang their heads and they go in the tank a little bit. Not in this case. Bounce back, took his team downfield, and threw a touchdown pass.
Now the point after try for Santos. And the lead is down to 24. So the drive there took six plays, and it culminates in a touchdown for Chicago. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. And this one's going to be covered up by the Packers hands team. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Coming up on the final 2.5 minutes, and boy, has it been fun to watch this offense operate. Quite the display, and now they look to polish it off. And he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down. On play action, now Rodgers. Flushed out right. It's caught here by Adams. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
You have fun with this one, partner?
I am. I mean, he's been
out, you know, getting to the next level, right? When we see people get into the zone, this guy's in the master class right now. What a performance he's putting on, just carving him up.
Four touchdown passes. Carving him up is right. Seems like everything he throws is going to be a completion and going in the end zone. Extra point try now for Crosby. Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. The long touchdown pass gets him six on a very, very tidy two-play drive that time. The touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Oh, the return from his end zone is Graham, and he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked out officially at the 21. The Chicago offense set to get started. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. So the Bears with the football here as we welcome you back. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score. Meanwhile, Fields' throw complete here to Kmet. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three.
And Brandon, as you know, sometimes it's a lot tougher to run with these tight ends nowadays in the NFL. They're just bigger wide receivers. He lined up on the left side of the formation, ran a drag route across the field, and tried to work his way open. He was able to make the catch, but the defenders were there, couldn't do a whole lot with it afterwards.
It's our field. Hey, it's our
Fields on third down. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Jair Alexander. And he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line. CD, this defense, I mean, at this rate, they're just having fun out there right now.
And normally with this type of a lead, if you're a starter on defense, you're saying, hey, let the other guys play. But with this going on, no one wants to come out of the game. They all want their shot at picking off a pass.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down. And now they're in the hurry up. Rodgers looking to throw. And this throw incomplete. Well, the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down. First quarter, Charles, you really emphasized the importance of winning the turnover battle as a visiting team, as an underdog. They haven't forced a single turnover in this game.
And right now they're losing, so no turnovers might lead to no victory.
Caught on the right side by Jones. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
Well, there's just about a minute left in this game, and they're still taking it into the end zone. And you know they could have taken a knee there, but they decided to play this one all the way out. And I think their philosophy is, we're going to give you everything we've got. If we just go ahead and take a knee now, we're actually showing you disrespect that way, like taking pity on you. They're not about to do that to their opponent.
Crosby connects on the extra point, and that will extend this big lead. So they only needed three plays on that drive. And it ends with a Packers touchdown. Touchdown. Here's Crosby to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as Grant opts not to return it for this Chicago offense. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now. And if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. They'll start with a give to Cohen. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
But from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. But let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage. Three-yard gains, that means they're punting the ball likely on fourth down. That's what you're looking for when you're playing defense.
Fields throw there, complete to Mooney. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds.
Timing is everything, and they work on this cut all the time. They work on all the timing patterns, and this time it paid off for him. Worked him to the center of the field, cut it to the outside, ball's delivered, gets both feet down for the completion.
On first down, it's Fields. Open man is Komet, the tight end. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. It's another 10 yards on that one and another first down. Back to throw, Fields. And this will be caught by Mooney. 7 yards, the pickup there. Second down and three. And one last throw here for Fields. And he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here. We've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory, and
The defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points, allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaud. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. The Packers are winners here as we say so long from Lambeau.